What's up everyone? I'm Mike and welcome back to Top Crypto. And today we're going to talk about another high potential project called Ceramic Network, but before we begin please notice our disclaimer. Since I'm not a financial advisor, so this video is for informational and educational purposes only. So without further ado, let's get to it. Ceramic is a decentralized data network that brings unlimited data composability to Web3 applications. Ceramic is a decentralized network for composable data. It makes building applications with composable Web3 data as easy as browsing a marketplace of data models, plugging them into your app, and storing, updating, and retrieving data from those models. When different applications reuse the same data models, their data is automatically interoperable. By decentralizing application databases, Ceramic makes data composable and reusable across all applications. How it works? Ceramic decentralizes application databases, making data universally composable and reusable across applications. The network consists of three core parts: a highly scalable, decentralized infrastructure for data availability and consensus, a marketplace of community-created data models, and a suite of standard APIs for storing, updating, and retrieving data from those models. Core components. The Ceramic network consists of three core components. Scalable, decentralized data infrastructure. The most foundational layer of Ceramic is its scalable, decentralized data network. The Ceramic network consists of a collection of permissionless nodes that work together to provide data availability for all states stored on the network and work to come to consensus about those states every time there is a new transaction. Data models marketplace. The second core component of Ceramic is its vibrant ecosystem of open-source data models created by the community, which serve to unlock cross-application data composability. Data models are a novel abstraction that unify how similar types of applications store and retrieve state from each individual user on the network. For example, you can imagine that every decentralized Twitter implementation would run on a few shared data models, one for each user's tweets, one for their social graph, one for their DMs, etc. By adopting the same underlying data models, applications are able to natively interoperate on the same data. Open APIs for data storage, update, and retrieval. The final core component of Ceramic is its permissionless, open APIs for storing, modifying, and retrieving data from the network. By standardizing, generalizing, and opening these APIs up to every developer in the world, Ceramic enables developers to build on top of shared resources stored on the network without fear of centralization, censorship risk, or lock-in. Decentralized data streams. With Ceramic's permissionless data streaming network, you can store streams of information and ever-changing files directly on the decentralized web and share updates with anyone in the world. Mutable streams. Store, edit, and update content in stateful data structures on IPFS. Immutable naming. Reference content by a persistent ID instead of changing IPFS hashes. Custom functions. Write custom functions to process updates to your stream state. Did authentication. Transact with streams using W3C standard decentralized identities. Scalable consensus. Per stream consensus ensures data consistency and network scalability. Host and deploy. Make your streams available over a global peer-to-peer network. Sync and share. Query, sync, or subscribe to any stream using standard APIs. Archive anywhere. Back up the contents of your stream to IPFS, Filecoin, or Amazon S3. Composability without limits. Applications connect to Ceramic's decentralized data network via an open API to store, modify, and retrieve data. All data that exists on the network can easily be reused or repurposed within other applications, creating a network of connected applications running on composable data. Build apps with Web3 data. Ceramic's decentralized data network has all the features and tools you need to build powerful applications with composable Web3 data. Decentralized identity. Build apps with interoperable, user-controlled data storage. DID data store supports DIDs for cross-chain IDs, streams for storage, and hubs for linking streams to a user. Identities are based on W3C standards and can be used with wallets from many different blockchains and Web3 platforms. Peer-to-peer databases. Store and host all of your user data or application data in streams to eliminate centralized database servers, blockchains, or local storage. Streams are a back-end replacement for storing user-generated content, user activity and history, application data and state, and much more. Evolutionary files. Store editable, version-controlled documents, files, and media on IPFS that maintain a transparent and auditable history without needing to keep track of changing hashes. Streams have been used to store social media posts, news articles, blogs and publications, JSON documents, schemas, metadata, NFT assets, and verifiable credentials. The ceramic stack. The ceramic application development stack consists of a few key components which are listed below, in order from highest level frameworks to lowest level network APIs. Frameworks. Frameworks abstract away much of the complexity and configuration of the underlying stack, providing developers with a simple entry point into ceramic development. In order to achieve simplicity, frameworks tend to be opinionated about how and what you build on the network. Middleware. Middleware is a generic name for all kinds of development tools that are not a part of the core ceramic protocol, but provide developers with additional functionality and convenience. Data models. Data models are collections of one or more streams, specified by their schemas and relationships, that define a single data structure on ceramic. Data models form the basis of composability on ceramic. When multiple applications reuse the same data model, they can reuse the same data. Typically, data models are used to represent an application feature such as a social graph or a user profile. Building with data models. Data models registry. The data models registry is home to the data models that developers wish to make available for reuse. We recommend starting there to discover which data models are available to use when building. Using data models from the registry promotes data composability by giving your application access to existing data on the network and helps avoid unnecessarily creating new data models. Creating new data models. If none of the data models in the data models registry suit your needs, you can create new data models using one of the methods below. After creating your data models, we recommend submitting them to the registry to enable reuse by others. Streams. Streams are individual instances of state on the ceramic network. Every stream that is created on ceramic must specify its stream code, which is a script that contains the processing logic used to transform a stream's current state into the next state upon receipt of a new transaction. In general, you can think of stream code as reusable state processing logic and streams as the individual states it generates. How streams work. Stream identifiers. Every stream is identified by its stream ID, which is its unique address on the ceramic network. When applications load a stream from the network using its stream ID, its current state is returned. Alternative, applications can load a previous version of a stream state by using the commit ID of the specific version wanted. Stream code. Every stream that is created on ceramic must reference a stream code in its metadata, which is a script that contains the processing logic used to transform a stream's current state into the next state upon receipt of a new transaction. In general, you can think of stream code as reusable state processing logic and streams as the individual states it generates. Today, ceramic supports two types of streams. Tile documents, which store mutable JSON documents with schema validation, and CAIP10 links, which store a link between a Web3 wallet account and a ceramic account. Accounts. Accounts are user entities on ceramic that can own streams and submit transactions to those streams. Ceramic accounts conform to the standard decentralized identifier, DID, specification, as outlined by the Decentralized Identity Foundation, DIF. DIDs are useful as they serve to unbundle ceramic accounts from any single Web3 wallet address or public key, allowing users to control the same ceramic account from one or more Web3 wallet accounts, and in the process providing an abstraction to enable truly cross-chain accounts. Building with accounts. In order for users to perform transactions on ceramic, they need an account. Your application can control which accounts it supports. When building with a ceramic client, you should install and configure the DID.json RPC client, which will instruct you how to add support for various account types. When building with a framework such as the Self-ID SDK, you don't need to worry about accounts, it will use 3ID DID. Client. Clients libraries allow your application to connect to a ceramic node. Different clients may choose to implement different high-level, language-specific developer APIs. Before submitting requests to a ceramic node, clients translate those API calls into the standard ceramic HTTP API, which it uses to actually communicate with the ceramic node. Types of clients. Ceramic clients. Ceramic clients are libraries that allow your application to communicate with a ceramic node. Different clients may choose to implement different high-level, language-specific developer APIs. Before submitting requests to a ceramic node, clients translate those API calls into the standard ceramic HTTP API, which it uses to actually communicate with a ceramic node. Account clients. Account clients are libraries that allow your application to recognize users, authenticate, and perform other account-related functionality such as signing transactions and encrypting data. Network APIs. The Ceramic HTTP API is the lowest-level interface for Ceramic. It is used under the hood by every client and node to communicate. Unless application developers have a specific need to use HTTP, most never need to interact with this API directly, instead accessing it via more developer-friendly client APIs. Protocol developers wishing to write a client in a new language, however, would need to use this specification. Meet the partners in leading Web3 projects. Avalanche, Ethereum, The Graph, Gnosis, and many more. Let's visit Ceramic's Twitter page. Ceramic already has 15.3 thousand followers and still rising. Let us witness Ceramic's pinned tweet. They're excited to announce that their community has raised a $30 million Series A led by MultiCoinCap and USV to accelerate development of Ceramic and unlock data composability in the Web3 ecosystem. It's time to realize the vision of an open, composable dataverse. And that's all for Ceramic Network. Come visit our channel, subscribe, and watch out for our next videos here at Top Crypto. Thanks for watching.